And we got a Skeletor here. If I can get these guys lined up right. Throw Skeletor on the end. Oh, two will stand up. There he is. Alright. Oh, Duncan. He almost dunked forward. Alright. Today on the channel, we're going to be unboxing Battle Armor He-Man. This is a Masters of the Universe new Eternia figure from Mattel Masterverse. Yeah, I wasn't going to buy this one, but dang, Walmart.com had it for $4.50. I feel like all his accessories were worth $4.50, so that's why I picked this one up. But I like to unbox everything I buy on the channel, so let's do it. There's the front of the box. Here is the back. Looking pretty cool. Looking like an older He-Man, really, to me. Here's the first side. This is Battle Armor He-Man. Most powerful armor in the universe. Funny. And there's Battle Armor He-Man, looking a little older, like I said. And the Masterverse logo on the top. Bottom is your barcode and legalese. I am going to scan up closer, not really scan, but just kind of pull it forward to that barcode if you need it. All right, let's set them here, pull the camera back, get a little closer look at everything, and then we'll get them unboxed. 30 points of articulation, that's pretty much all these Masterverse figures. They say that. There's another barcode up there. And there's a 40th anniversary of He-Man logo right there. Let's get that where the light can see it. Looking cool. I like it. By the power of Grayskull! He's got the power. 6+. And there's a big axe. Not great paint work on that axe, I'll say. But something I could probably work on. Handle looks cool. The power sword. He's got a pretty cool handle on that as well. And there he is. Beardy long hair He-Man. With a scar. Yeah, it's definitely an older He-Man. And his battle armor, and it does have, whatever reason, when you get a battle armor He-Man, you can always take the plate out where the H is, and it's got big cuts in it, but that can be replaced. And it comes with a cool shield, too, so I like that. A couple extra hands. There's the bottom with the new Eternia logo on there. The back. This is the universe, new Eternia. Original designs inspired by classic concepts. That's pretty cool. There's Battle Armor He-Man blurb if you'd like to read about it. And there he is. Very cool. Go ahead and scan it down. You can see those creatures. Man, I wish I would make this figure. I'd buy that in a heartbeat. He looks so cool. Even this guy. Make those. Those are cool. Make these an army builder. Make these army builders. I would buy those in a heartbeat. Those are cool. And the bottom. We got this Battle Armor He-Man. I did not buy Sunman. I did not buy Hero. I did not buy Jitsu. I know Jitsu, I had the original action figure as a kid, but I don't know. I don't even know what Hero and Sunman are. I'm going to be very honest. But yeah, those are also available. Sunman you can get pretty cheap. I saw Hero in the store for retail. Just didn't really want it. And I saw Jitsu on sale at a place, but I didn't buy it. I don't know. Maybe someday, if they get really cheap, I'll pick them up, like Sunman already is, but I don't know, we'll see. I don't know, $4.50 for Battle Armor He-Man, you can't beat that. Hey, did you notice his beard is really brown here? His hair, he looks totally different. That did not look the same as what we just saw. Take a look at that. And that. Totally not the same. He does look better with brown beard, I would say. I might have to paint mine brown. All right, let's get them open. So I think I do these from the top because there's just one piece of tape on these Masterverse figures. So I'm going to set it like this. Go tilt down. Let me grab my X-Acto knife. Going to cut that tape while I'm doing that. Just want to say if you're enjoying this video, if you could give it a like, if you enjoy action figure unboxings, toy hunts, shelf tours. If you haven't yet subscribed to Hey, What That On My Shelf, go ahead and do that and you'll get that all in your feed. And if you have a fun comment, that is always greatly welcome. Greatly appreciated. All right, let's get Battle Armor He-Man, Old Man He-Man out the box. There we go. Just got some rocks in the background there. Rockage, rock looking. All right, so looks like we got some plastic ties. Let me grab my clippers. Flip those off. Looks like they're on the power sword. I don't know if there's any other than that. That was to keep the power sword in place. And this is a pretty nice looking power sword, I will say. I like the grip on it. It looks nice. Shield. Whoa, that just popped around on the floor. I actually haven't dropped anything on the floor in a while, so I was due, and it was this shield. How does he hold this shield if it's just a little peg? Is this really just going on his back? Usually there's like a little clip, and it can clip to his arm. This is weird. I don't know. We'll see how that works out. Let's get that axe. There it is. Pretty cool looking axe, other than no paint. The wrap is really nice. It's got a little silver at the bottom. But yeah, a little paint up in there would have been nice. But it can be made to look real cool. Alright, I don't think I need the clippers anymore. See, this is that plate that hooks to his chest if you want him to look like he's been battle damaged. A couple of hands. Oh my gosh, they were in there deep. So you gotta, please sir, may I have another hand? A punchy fist that almost went on the floor. And let's get him out. Okay, he does have plastic ties. I think they are on his arm and his leg. I pulled through one. Actually, I think I'm just gonna try to pull him out. I'm not gonna cut these. We're just gonna He-Man straight out of this. Yeah, we don't need a clippers. No way. He-Man's out. He looks a little messed up, but he's all right. Okay, I see where the shield goes. It goes in that weird little port on his hand, on his arm. Get this out of here. He's cool and weird at the same time. I don't know how else to put it. I think his pose just looks really off. He just looks too like, huh? What's that in? I don't know. I think it's just the... I don't know. He looks strange up in here. Okay, so you can put the shield on the back. Like, I figured you probably would be able to. And then you can put the shield on his arm, which I think looks better. It's upside down, but something like that's pretty cool looking. I do like that. That's a cool accessory to have that. This armor just does not want to stay on. I think that's what I'm sensing is so weird about this figure. There's no, like, it's over his bicep, but it doesn't want to stay. Like, it'll stay until you move it, well, kind of. Don't love that. Probably going to pull that off. I don't know. I'm guessing this piece can come off. I hope so, because it'd be cool to use this in other figures. No, it doesn't come off. Like, are you sure? Does it come off? I don't know. It's not moving, but it sure looks like it should be able to come off. I don't know. Otherwise, it looks like Mega Man. With his blaster. Yeah, I don't know. I really thought that was going to come off. Usually this stuff comes off, but it's on there so tight. I don't know. Maybe it's glued in. Maybe if I really wanted to, I could get it off. Yeah, but it feels glued in. Get that back in. This armor, I do hate it. It does not stay. Maybe if you go way up the arm, that's a little better. I think you gotta just get it on just right. I think that's the issue, but if you go too high, it's... No? It goes over the top. Okay, I think... Alright, I'm wrong. It's not bad. It just needs to be put on correct to make it work. Okay. Alright, I don't hate it as much now. This plate... See if we can pop that off. Ah, there we go. That looks weird without it. And then you can just stick this one in there if you want a busted up looking He-Man plate. I don't know. It goes in kind of funky. There we go. But it goes in. There it is. He's wearing this armor. Don't know if you could pull it off, and I don't know if you'd want to because it looks like his torso is this silver no matter what. Oh, he... Okay. Whoop, on the floor. This is what his torso looks like. So this doesn't even come off, this back piece. So this is part of him. It does not come off. This does not come off. I thought I was going to be able to use this armor on another figure. Nope. That is connected to his body. Very different than this He-Man that just came out not too long ago that I did an unboxing of. Look at that. Look at that. Axe looks so much better than this one. It's just because it's got paint. This one does not. So, and this armor, this whole piece comes off. I obviously could do the whole thing where it looks like it's slashed here too. But this whole armor comes off and it's just his body underneath. This is funky. Now I know why he was $4.50. You cannot use any of this for anything else. So that kind of stinks. He's always the armor guy. I guess you could do a head swap if you had to. Keep him in his armor. I don't know. And it's kind of funky to get this line back up. There we go. Let's throw his regular logo back in there. I think you're supposed to actually pull this off, throw this on here, and then put his armor back on is how you're supposed to do it. I don't know how I did it the first time. But yeah, it's funky. That's for sure. Alright, let's get this. Yeah. I don't know. He almost seems taller, too. Nah, he's about the same height-ish. Interesting. But yeah, this is much better He-Man, for sure. Battle Armor He-Man. Alright, let's check out the one that we're looking at here now. Let's do some articulation. Did I show all the accessories, though? Yeah, I did. Okay. So for the head, it is just a ball joint going in on the top. You can pop his head off. There it is. So actually, it's a ball joint on the top of the head, and then the bottom, it's just got a little front and back movement like that. So put that back on. There's your head up. Your head down. Not a whole lot of side to side because of that hair. So not a ton of head movement, but you get enough, I guess. The arms, so you got a peg going in on the rocker there for the shoulder. You've got the bicep cut there, which is good. Double jointed elbow, no pins. Never any pins on these Mattel figures. I love it. And then an up and down rocker for the hand. Looks like they're all up and down rockers. Every hand is. The waist, so you got a ball joint up in here, up in the top. There's your lean back. Knock the arm off again. Lean back. Lean forward, side to side and twisty. As far as a waist cut, he should have one. He just doesn't want to move. He's got this weird... There we go. Yep. So he's got his waist cut. It is just a peg, so you can move it around. And then the legs. This is soft plastic. This is soft also, but it is kind of cumbersome. There is a peg going in. A ball joint going in the leg. Kick to the side is there. Kick forward is here. And I just noticed he's got a knife. Does that come out? Cool! So he does have another accessory. Alright. Boot knife. There's a kick forward. Actually, his boot cut's kind of funny. That's your actual kick forward right there. Kick back to there. Double jointed. Before we do that, there is a bicep. Not bicep, jeez. There's a thigh cut right here. Gets a little funky, but it's so covered up you won't even know. Double jointed knee, that is so tight. Oh my. There we go. Double jointed knee, get you way back. No pins, I love it. And he's got that boot cut, so just a peg, so you can swivel it around, looks great. And then a front facing pin on a rocker for the foot. You know, for $4.50, pick this thing up. Why not? $4.50, you could do a head swap. Let's see how this other head looks on this, if you wanted to, for the heck of it. Skin tone is pretty darn close. It's not bad. And then if you wanted an older He-Man on this body, there you go. It's not a bad head sculpt, really. I actually kind of like it. Yeah, for $4, $4.50, you can't beat that. So obviously this is a better figure here. Like they upgraded it quite a bit. But for $4.50, again, boy, it's hard to beat this figure. You need a figure with some extra accessories. It would be nice if this could come off. I'll probably try to break it off at some point and see if I could use it for other figures, because I do like the fact that you can put the shield on there. I do wish it didn't have this and it just had the regular shield that had the two clips that kind of just hooked in. I like that better. But it is what it is. I like the accessories. This power sword looks great. And this axe is cool. Needs a little paint, but it's cool. And the extra hand. So, a lot of cool accessories. Even it has a knife here. I don't know if I showed it that good. It doesn't... I mean, it kind of has paint and little bronze. It works. Little knife there in the boot. Alrighty. Let's throw everything that he came with, which is quite a bit. Shot of everything. That's everything that comes with the new Attorney of Battle Armor He-Man. Right there looks pretty good. Let's wipe away those accessories and throw some other figures for scale. I forgot to grab any. I will be right back with some figures. Don't go anywhere. Okay, back. Here's Man-at-Arms. Why not? I'm getting the stand. Good old Duncan. Tila. And we got a Skeletor here, if I can get these guys lined up right. Let's throw Skeletor on the end. Come on, Tila, stand up. There he is. All right. Oh, Duncan. He almost dunked forward. All right. That's looking pretty good. All right. There is your Battle Armor He-Man. Stay tuned for some posing. Thanks so much for watching.